Walsamu is one of their enforcers, was just there. He didn't even involve himself.
But here's the question. It happened in front of the bench of LaSalle. What is your demarcation mark of who leads the bench? Is it on the court? Does it happen on the corner? Right in the corner near the coolers, where the coolers are stationed for LaSalle.
Was there anybody from UEU left the bench? We're all going to try to clear that out, but that is total inexperience.
And we were talking about inexperience of the big man. In a big game.
In a big game like this. A foul by Rico Meyerhofer. We've seen harder fouls before.
Right. Yeah.
So...
And it's a playoff hard foul.
Exactly.
Let's put it that way. It's a playoff hard foul.
Coach Franz was there. Joey Santamaria was there. But
Bangas has left the bench. If you call that leaving the bench, so did Ilad.
But Bangas was trying also.
Right. But still, you can't leave the bench.
Yes, exactly.
You cannot leave the bench as a player.
But what constitutes as leaving the bench if you're there?
And it looks like some UA players were not able to leave the bench because
they were prevented.
It was the coaches who first ran, so it looks like they prevented them.
I think so. I think they were prevented. Now, this is so unfortunate, DJ. In a game that was so much hype involved, the relevance, the importance, significance and ramifications of this game.
Don't forget, whatever happens in this game, we'll get thrown out or what. They're both still in the semifinals, whether it's a final four or step out of format. So if you lose a key player due to suspension in an all-important knockout game or a final four game, or for UE, could even be a finals game.
Yes,
you
that's
could lose
true.
A key player for the first game of the finals if somebody left the bench.
Somebody did. Those are a lot of questions, and obviously, as you look at the sea of red in front of you...
And you know what's so rare here? We have the referees in front of us. It seems like all of the UAAP Board of Governors
are
on the floor.
We have Mr. Ricky Palu, Ricky Desagon, Father Desagon is here.
That is so rare to see them all on the floor, huddling with Commissioner Ed Cordero. I mean, this is when a commissioner does his job.
Exactly.
You know, if a board meeting is held, they do it after the game. Well, in any case, they're on the job and they're on the ball. They want to help out as much as they can.
And Cholo Villanueva was already pulling out Rico Meyerhofer para hindi na magano'n.
So who leaves the bench for LaSalle?
Lingane wanted to get into it. France already was really...
Ilad, may puelo pa eh.
Oo eh.
Bang. Back of the head punch. So he's obviously going to get thrown out. It's so clear in the tape. So it seems like Ilad was the only who left the bench. Maybe even Mangas didn't leave the bench.
Yes, I think so. That would be a fair assessment. Yeah. And Coach Dito saw it from afar.
Yeah.
And look at JV hollering at Bryan Ilad. Coach Jack Santiago also on Bryan Ilad's case. They're telling them that it wasn't called for.
Right.
Why do we get involved in these things, TJ?
Kakataon sa atin talaga. But you know what's unfortunate for this situation? I'm sure all the fans of these two teams is magkapatid yung mga coach eh. Parang of all the teams that will be rivals, it's not little rivals in the court, but I don't think they have such a heated rivalry to escalate to something like this.
Yes. And it just gets tougher when it's in front of your bench, you know? Parang there's that sense of territory.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You don't want to mess with somebody on the opposing bench.
And again, this is where, and I will have to point this out, TJ, you know, that maturity and mental part of the game comes in. You saw JV Casho, you saw PJ Walsham. They didn't move an inch. They let Coach Frank Kumarin resolve
them. And the assistant coaches
push
him away. But unfortunately, all the assistant coaches went on the floor to pull away the players on the floor.
Exactly.
That's first in my call, number 10, Rico Meyerhofer. His first four of the LaSalle.
Is it a foul or flagrant foul?
Technical foul on number 5, Mark Fampulme, for taunting.
Taunting and Fampulme. That's a good
call. Disqualifying foul on number 15, Bryan Ilad, for punching.
And sportsmen like playing
in it.
So Ilad's out of the game.
Technical foul on both benches.
Both benches.
Ilad is out of the game.
Was it because the coaching staff moved? The bench of UE?
I'm sorry, there was. I don't know why they want to stop a technical on both benches still. But nonetheless, Ilad's out of this game, and potentially, more than likely, be suspended at least one game for either a playoff against Ateneo or the first game of the Final Four matchup against Ateneo, whoever has the advantage.
Just as we were pointing out, the role of the bigs in this game.
And you know, put it in perspective, Bryan Ilad is a guy who's used relatively with a good amount of playing time. 14 minutes a game, averages 4 points, and almost five rebounds a game. So he is still an interesting guy on the floor, especially against teams that have formidable big man lineups, like UE and Ateneo.
This game. In this first quarter, by the way, we are only in the first quarter of a game very, very important. UAE trying to make history. I'm sure it's just a subplot of their wanting to win today.
They
want to win. And if they do, they go straight to the finals. But if they do win, they sweep the elimination, something that has not been done since 1993. For LaSalle, securing that number two spot, regardless of who the opponent is, regardless of the streak that they have to break, that's at the back of their heads, if they're even thinking of it at all.
Now, you want to look ahead at this game, the implications on the emotions,
yes,
the intensity,
yes,
and the aggressiveness of this game. Who will it affect in either way, either positive or negative?
Yes.
I'd say that the level of intensity we saw at the start of this game, mataas na, pero kaya mo kumating.
Yep.
And I think this incident will even put up, he needs ice in his head, of course. I think this incident is going to put up that level of intensity and aggressiveness a couple of notches higher.
Just to highlight, underline the importance of the game for both teams for different reasons. As Mark Bordoran makes one out of two for a one-point lead. Now we finally will resume play.
So was that for the technical foul?
Technical
punching foul.
Yes.
Because normally, yung pinaka basic foul, yun ang huling ibibigay, which is the foul of my Hoffer.
Okay.
Which I don't know though even if it's going to be two free throws because the ball is down.
Yes.
Our
referee is talking to the captain, Steve White Tang, and Marcia Arellano, trying to put order back into this game. Not even the Ateneo LaSalle game had an incident like this.
But there was almost one.
Well, yeah.
Almost, but nothing that went down on this game. Yeah. Inches away from the bench of LaSalle. Kaya talaga mas tempting yung... Ganun talaga. That's basketball.
And inexperience in a situation like this came into play for Bryan Ilad. In other words, he let his emotions get a hold of him. Meyerhofer on the brink of the disqualification. Mariagas. On the line.
For the big first quarter. He had 8 of his 10 points in the first quarter.
6 teams, as we mentioned earlier, have tried their luck on UE. Not once, but twice. And some of them have failed miserably. LaSalle has the last chance to try to beat UE.
Look at this, dude. The LaSalle bench is up in arms now. Complaining about the lack of a defensive rebound or a possible goaltending because the ball was being rebounded, someone hung onto the rim and shook that rim. But nonetheless, another offensive rebound for UE, and Hans Piero is back on the line where he made a living of it in the third quarter.
And really, that's the stat that will blow this game away. 29 offensive rebounds, 27 total rebounds for LaSalle. Offensive rebounds. DLSU has 27 total rebounds.
29 offensive rebounds. That's insane.
And they're only... We actually have 4 minutes and 26 seconds remaining here.
But interesting, amidst the dominance of the boards, they're not dominating the game.
And they're only up by 2.
Exactly, they're only up by 2.
And why is that, DJ?
Other factors have not been into play. Look at the guards that only come up here in the fourth quarter, but prior to that, they've been quiet. 17 turnovers a game, but as of coming into the fourth quarter, they already had 17.
Barakas tries again. Still no roll. Chances for LaSalle.
And good looks at that.
Yeah.
Had good looks.
3:48. This game is winding down. Only against Barakas. They set it up to Martinez. Back to Pauline. Tough angle. And a rebound by D.Y. Tango.
That's what you need. The LaSalle small guys have to help on the boards.
D.Y. goes to his right. Adjusts and gets wild and got bailed out by a defensive foul by Hans Dieler. And now the veterans come in. Rico Meyerhofer, Sola Villanueva, P.J. Walsham are all stepping in for the windup. As we give you our Canon power shot, power play of the game, we captured this reverse by Marcia Arellano on PJ Walsham.
3:28 to go, and Coach Franz Pumaren already risking his veterans who have four personal fouls. That's Meyerhofer back on the floor.
Cash is still on the bench, though. But he will be there for the windup. You can bet whatever you want to bet on that.
Most probably he'll be pulling out Malabes if Malabes is not yet hot.
Tang makes the first free throw. 14 points for T.Y. Tang. 72.5% from the free throw line. Reminding you about the Samsung UAP Sports Center every Tuesday, 5:30 p.m. Recaps, highlights, scores, Ultimate Game, Ultra Series, and your Ultimate Baller every 5:30 on Studio 23.
This week.
We always have a tough time. More so this week. Martinez against Tang. Six on their 24. Coming up the 3-minute mark of this ballgame. Marcy attacks. Gets creative. He manufactures a reverse shot to give them three-point lead.
That's what I was saying. You're going to need the guards to step up. The veteran guards have to step up here in crunch time.
Marcy on Pader. They go to PJ. PJ looks at his options. Six on their 24. PJ out to DY. DY, nowhere to go.
I think they wasted too much time trying to set up PJ Walsham. He was not even showing much in this game.
And now JB Cascio is back in for Bader Malabes. Coach Franz Pumaren. They lose this, they have to pray Ateneo loses to NU on Saturday.
If they want to have a crack at second place.
And of course they do. That goes without saying. Second place obviously guarantees twice the beat advantage regardless of whether it's a Final Four or a step ladder. Today, no more Final Four complication for them. 2 seconds on the shot clock, and Marcia Arellano travel. That's a good call.
Yep, and a great defensive set there by LaSalle. Not fouling this time around. Remember, they have so many fouls already this quarter. They were in penalty with 6:59 to go in the fourth.
2:13. Mark Fampulme moves out, or moves in for Marcia Arellano. Everybody clutching on to anything that they can hang on to here at the Araneta Coliseum for this thrilling windup. Cascio in a hurry. Three on three. Fakes. Goes up. Gets it.
Murray's defense caught napping on the inbound play.
And he just took advantage of it.
Yep.
Last 2 minutes brought to us by PS Bank. 73-72. Borgoran with a drive. Oh, what a goal!
Patient play there by Yui, not forcing it on the jump shot from the outside, still going for the high percentage shot.
Cascio for three, short, and a rebound secured by Mark Borgoran. Whoops, Tolo trying to fight for possession.
How many times have we said that in this game, though? Yui securing that defensive rebound.
It's not just getting it, it's
secure,
really securing.
Yeah, you described it perfectly.
75-72 in the 13 games of UE. A few have been real tests to the Red Warriors, and they've passed it with flying colors. They're trying to do that again today. Puts it in the face of Rico Meyerhofer for a 5-point lead with a minute and 18 seconds remaining.
Oh, the foul here on Pauline. And if I'm not mistaken, Yui is also in the penalty.
look at our Nike Spotlight Baller of the Game, Bryan Ilad.
He set the tone. He set the tone for UE and the rest of the big men with that 8 points in the first quarter alone.
And we will remind you, Salle is 4-0 in the last 5 years after coming off Ateneo losses. Reminding you of the replays on Sky Cable, Channel 61. As they're working on Marcia Arellano, who probably is suffering from a little bit of cramps right now.
It's interesting to have him out of the game in this situation.
That's how much trust he has with a lot of the other players. Be right back. Gets them closer. Minute 15, 77-74 earlier today. FEU forcing the playoff match for number 4 against USD.
Completing a sweep of USD this year, knocking them out in the first and second round.
Yeah, that's another side bet. So we will have a playoff for number 4. They will meet again. Beat by. A minute to play. 24 of UE. They have a 3-point lead. We're looking at a 4-second shot clock. Martinez sneaks in. And a rebound by BJ Walsham. A very important one.
Yes, all important defensive rebound there by Walsham.
BY Bang sets up Manas.
Could have been double dribbling.
BY Bang shoots the three. Nothing there. Offensive rebound by LaSalle. Walsham is near the lead.
That was big. Big pass there by Manas. They're down by one.
30 seconds remaining. Everybody and his mother standing up here at the big dome. An 11-second differential between the clock, the game clock, and the shot clock. Execution will be a goal. Yeah. And a chance here for LaSalle, DJ.
You really wonder why Marcy Arellano is not in the game at the last few seconds for UE. They could have called the timeout. They set up a last play, but they didn't.
And speaking of which, let's call this Samson timeout with Samson. It's not that hard to imagine. DLSU is one stop away. Oh, sorry, UE is one stop away from making history or repeating history.
They are the best defensive team in the league. And let's see if they can prove it right here, right now.
13 seconds on the shot clock. LaSalle has a chance to snatch this from UE. Jamie Gasso, cross the foul. Oh. He will go to the line with 3.5 seconds left.
But interestingly, he will have two free throws, 3.5 seconds left. UE,
two timeouts.
Has still two timeouts left, which is something I was ranting about at the break, why they didn't call a timeout earlier when they lost that ball. So UE, whatever happens, if Gasso makes a second free throw, they can still advance that ball.
DLSU are 2-2 this season on games decided by 5 points or less. Gasso has not shot a free throw in this game, but on the average, he is a 78% shooter, and UE will freeze J.V. Gasso first.
Freeze and make him feel this pressure a little bit longer.
We have a Samson timeout with Samson. It's not that hard to imagine.
Intensity like no other.
Back here at the Arenita Coliseum, nerves are running. That's what we're feeling here at the Arenita. Everybody saying a prayer for different reasons. Jamie Gasso in the pressure cooker. Gut check for him. No free throws today so far.
One last timeout, 3.5 seconds to go. They will advance this ball to the half-court line.
DJ, the only our fifth deadlock of the ball game, and let's listen to Coach Dito right now.
Nick, papalitan si Kelvin. Oh, oh, oh. Ha?
Ming. Ming. James. Oh, wait. Kelvin. Mark. Dito ka, Mark. Okay, ganito gagawin natin. Pagka hindi sila nakano, listen. Pag lahat sila narito. Pag lahat sila narito, baba tayo ng konti. Okay, Marcy. Lee. Oh. Okay, ganito gagawin natin. Dito, Mark, dito ka. Bigla kang pumlash. Flash, Mark. Lee, ikaw maglabas. Kelvin, dito ka. Kelvin. De, wait. Kelvin. Si Mark dito. Si Lee maglalabas. Ah, Marcy maglalabas. Lee. Kelvin. Marcy. Ali. James. Marcy maglalabas. Kern. Labas. Flash ka. Dito si Kelvin. Mark, flash. Hit. Hand over. Hey, Marcy.
We're looking for the handoff. Right. Well, you notice.
Oh, boy.
The pressure.
This is the UAAP.
This is it.
The pressure, the tears, the prayers.
You notice the pressure on Coach Tito Bumal. He was feeling it. He could not decide on a play till the very last few seconds of that timeout, but he wants to go to Mark Burburan as the first recipient and then giving it off to Marcy Arellano for a quick handoff. Hopefully, going straight baseline. Let's see how this develops.
3.5 seconds remaining. That's what's standing between UAAP and a perfect elimination round.
What? It's a turnover. Turnover. Burburan lost the handle, and it bounced on the line.
LaSalle,
no more timeouts for LaSalle.
Six turnovers in the fourth quarter to the one of LaSalle here. Oh, boy. When you think we've seen it all during that Ateneo LaSalle match, we're back here where we started. 77 all, fifth deadlock of the ball game. 1.8 seconds remaining.
UAAP does not want to foul right now, not with the way they bailed out Jim Cash earlier.
1.8 seconds. Find out what's going to happen.
Oh no for LaSalle. Nobody touched that ball. So the ball will be inbounded all the way back there.
What happened to Rico?
He just lost sight of the ball.
Oh.
You know what? It could be the bright lights in the ceiling.
Oh, yes.
If you look up here and try to catch a high looping ball, you'll get blinded by the lights. And he was like 5 feet away from the ball.
And he had nobody in front of him.
Nobody at all. He caught that ball. He would have had that basket easy.
What a bizarre.
Oh, but the refs are claiming that the ball was tapped. By who? By the inbounder defender? Probably.
Yes, I guess.
Who tapped it? UE is arguing the point. They want the inbound here.
He sent me 1.3 seconds.
But that could be the mistake of the scorer's table.
Okay.
For pressing the button when the ball came into play.
But you're not supposed to press the button until somebody touches, right?
Commissioner Ed Cordero is on the court right now, instructing his head officials to do something. I don't know if he can catch him in time before the ball is inbounded. The referee at the baseline is looking at Commissioner Ed Cordero now, seeing if they're going to overrule this. Looks like they're not. They're calling it. There was a tap.
That's why you go rookie clock.
Okay. Here's the replay. It didn't look like there was a tap from the heave of Casho. Will there be a tap here?
Oh, Rico was like...
Was Rico the one who tapped it?
I think so. I think that's the call. And Coach Franz Fulanet, yeah. You know, the opportunity to win it was there.
It was there.
But it just wasn't meant to be. So this is the longest 3.5 seconds I've experienced. Now we're down to 1.3. With UE inbounding all the way back.
I think Simon Atkins is way too far from Arellano here. We're going to give him a chance for one dribble in the lead.
Arellano puts it up. That's long. It's this character and mental fortitude and resiliency as Coach Franz Fulanet has led DLSU to the finals 8 out of 9 times for an 89% clip. It cannot get better than that.
I don't think it can get any sweeter for LaSalle and for Coach Franz Fulanet, the way nobody has beaten UE in this season after 14 tries.
And again, they win when it mattered in the season.
Hey, what's going on? Kobe Bryant here. Congratulations to DLSU Green Archers for winning the UAAP Finals. Respect to the team for bringing it to the next level. Annie Mola Salle.